more today, God. And we won't just sit back and be silent. God, we won't let the things, the cares of this world weigh us down to the point to where we can't open our mouths and give you all that's due your name. God, you are worthy. You are worthy, Father. You know every tear drop.
Thank you.
Come on and talk to your God. He's awesome to you. Hallelujah, Jesus, you're so awesome. You're a great, great God. Yes, you are. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah,
we Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How great is it to you this morning? You have to make it personal every once in a while. Come on, come on, come on. Let's give him some praise this morning. He said, he will be lifted up. He will draw men. Let's lift him up in this place today. Come on, come on. How great is it in your life? My. Yes, Lord, you are great. My. I know it's a few of us in here, but he said he'll deliver by a few of us. As long as your heart is expecting the Lord to do something for you today, especially in this place. If you lay all your faults and everything that so easily besets you at the feet of the Lord, he will take that thing from you. You know? I've been struggling because my mom is sick. And I talk to her every day. And it's different. Because I call her there and sometimes she don't know who's on the phone with her. And I tell you, it's hard. But I know God don't make mistakes. It's very hard. This time of year, I normally be waiting for a package to come in the mail. She'll cook cakes and send them to me in the mail. She's not able to do that no more. But I tell you what, I've given it to the Lord, and he's given me peace in that situation. He's given me peace in that situation. And I know he still do miracles. And I'm looking for him to do a miracle. And right now, I'm a man under authority, so I want you to agree with me, because the centurion said, I'm a man under authority, so I'm just sending the word to touch her right now. Yes, Lord. Don't have to physically be there, but he's omnipresent. He's everywhere. So he's right there with her right now. And I know he's able to do it exceedingly and abundantly. My. You ought to be excited this morning, I tell you. I'm not worried about getting a gift on the tree, because I got the gift of life. And I've seen how precious that gift is. And I'm in my right mind. My. I just thank the Lord this morning for what he's doing. And you know, if she don't regain all her cognitive, I can say, I'm fine with that, because the Lord has truly blessed her for 83 years on this earth. Even through cancer battles, through it all. I don't know if you ever seen the children come on TV called Big Mama. She's Big Mama to everybody. We fed more people we don't know than we fed people we know. But I'm here to tell you, if and when he called on the glory, that too, I'm settled with. Because I know she believed in her Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And she did that and committed to him in her right mind. So you need to think about doing and committing to things while you're in your right mind. Amen? Amen. I just want to thank you all for joining us this morning. What an honor and a privilege it is to be in the house of the Lord. No other place during this time of year I would rather be. No other place. My. I'm not going to prolong the time. At this time, we're going to have our offering. And right after our offertory scripture, we'll have a small song. And the next voice you will hear will be none other than my rib. My wife, Elder Tricia Barnes. Amen. Praise God. Amen. This morning's offertorial scripture will come from Psalm, the 97th division of Psalm. Praise God. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praises to the Most High. It is good to proclaim your unfailing love in the morning, your faithfulness in the evening, accompanied by the 10-string harp and the melody of the lyre. You thrill me, Lord, with all you have done for me. I sing for joy because of what you have done. Oh, Lord, what great work you do, and how deep are your thoughts. Dear Lord, we thank and we praise you, God, for who you are, God. We give you praise, God, this morning, and we continue to praise you all the day through. Now, Lord, thank you for this ability to give, God. Thank you for what is given for, God, that we might continue to give praise and glory unto your name for all you have done for us, God, and for all you continue to do. Now be with us, God, and continue to bless. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Thank God. Amen. You're in the hands of the ushers at this time.
Where that song says, and my heart will sing.
and my heart will sing how great is our, and my heart will, So I changed it up a little bit. I said, and my heart does sing how great is my God. My heart does sing how worthy is my God. My heart does sing how mighty is my God. My heart. I don't know what your heart is saying, but my heart. My heart says that he is worthy of the praise. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, hello, chef. I thought y'all was tired from last night. But it seems like we might have a little something. Hey. Something going on this morning. Hey. Come on. We're excited about God. We're excited about who he is. We're excited about the things that he has done. We're excited that he has kept us. We're excited about our God. I'm excited about what he's doing in my mother-in-law's life. I'm excited about what he's doing in your life. I'm excited about God. Hey. Hallelujah. I'm excited about the Lord this morning. And I'm going to give him praise until I die. Hallelujah. I'm going to give him praise until I can't lift up my hands anymore. I'm going to give him praise until I can't stomp my feet anymore. I'm going to give him praise. Hey! I'm going to give him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It don't matter what's going on in my life. It don't matter what's going on in my body. My God deserves the praise. Hey, God. He deserves the praise. My bank account might be little enough praise, but I'm going to praise him anyhow. Tell the Bobby, I might have to have some surgery, but I'm going to lift up my hands anyway. I'm going to make my way to the house of the Lord anyhow. Because he's worthy, 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 worthy. My heart sings. My heart sings hallelujah. My heart sings hallelujah. My heart sings hallelujah. My heart sings hallelujah. Oh, my heart sings hallelujah.
place this morning.
Come on, you got one more chance. Maybe you didn't see it either.
Hey!
right. For what you need now, the atmosphere is right. Will you receive from the Lord? It's right now. Will you receive from the Lord?
Utterly fall, but they that wait Yes, I am here, he reply. Remove the heavy yoke of oppression. Stop pointing your fingers and spreading vicious rumors. Feed the hungry and help those in trouble. Then your light will shine out from darkness, and the darkness around you will be as bright as noon. The Lord will guide you continually, giving you water when you are in a dry, when you are dry, and restoring your strength. You will be like a well-watered garden. Hallelujah. Like an ever-flowing spring. I'm sorry, I'm reading the New Living Translation. He says, some of you will rebuild the deserted ruins of your city. Sound like the grounds we're on. Then you will be known as a rebuilder of walls and a restorer of homes. Keep the Sabbath day holy. Do not pursue your own interests on that day, but enjoy the Sabbath and speak of it with delight as the Lord's holy day. Honor the Sabbath and everything you do on that day, and don't follow your own desires or talk idly. Then the Lord will be your delight. I will give you great honor and satisfy you with the inheritance I promised your ancestors. I want to look at verse 9 again. He says, then you will call. The Lord will answer. Yes, I am here. He will quickly reply. Isaiah 65:24. It says, I will answer them before they even call to me. Before you can fix your mouth, before you can form whatever you need, before the answer is already on the way, before you even ask. Remember when Daniel prayed? So Daniel kept praying. He kept praying for 21 days. He kept praying. But the angel said this when he showed up. He said, when you set your heart to seek, the answer came then. The answer was released when you set your heart. God says, I'm releasing answers. I'm releasing answers that you have not seen yet. Things that you have asked me for, things that you have been pleading for, I want you to know that the answer has already been released. I will answer them before they even call me. Listen. While they are still talking about their needs, while you're still talking about the problem, while you're still talking about the issue, already got it. He said, while they are still talking about their needs, I will go ahead and answer their prayer. We talk about how awesome our God is and how great He is, but do we realize how great His love is for us? That before we go through what we're going through, He's already released the answer. He's already released the solution before we deal with trouble. How great is our God? So our hearts, gotta sing how great our God is. Our hearts gotta know how great our God is. it's on the way. No food on the table? God, I don't know where it's coming from, but what I do know is that it's on the way. Whatever the situation, our God is bigger than that. We have to realize how much He loves us, more than the birds of the air, more than the flowers of the field, who are here today and gone tomorrow, more than that. Woo. I believe God is trying to get us to a place that we're no longer sitting back saying what I'm waiting for God to do. I don't like when folks tell me what God is getting ready to do. Tell me what God is doing. Tell me what He's doing. Can you see Him? Can you trace Him in your life? Have you seen Him move for you before? Have you seen Him move? Then tell me what God is doing. When you set your heart to seek His face. But when you set your heart, why do you think your heart posture is so important? This is why I don't like when people say, I'm going to do this, but God knows my heart. So why is your heart so important? When you set your heart towards God, that's important. God, I'm giving this to you. My aim is just to please you. My aim is for nothing else, Lord God, than for you to have your way in my life. When you set your heart. See, Daniel realized that some things was happening. So Daniel said, I'm going to go and I'm going to talk to God about it because I want to know what's going on. If you want to know what's going on, ask God, the one that knows. Too busy checking to see what Fox got to say. But what is God saying about the matter? What is God saying about politics? What is God saying about the church? What is God saying about it? Are we trying to find out? Are we forming our own opinion? I want to know what God is doing. Because not only am I excited about what He's doing in my life, I'm excited about what He's doing in Victor and Erica. Because we are a community of believers, and when we come together, we ought to be encouraging and building up and lifting up one another. There's enough going on outside the door. And when I come in here, I need to see a friendly face. When I come in here, I need to feel an embrace that's for real. When I come in here, it's not all on Pastor and Lady Gibson. She gives them good hugs, but don't she? But it's not all on them. It's on all of us. So that the world may see, so that when the lost come in, that they see that God is moving in this place, that God is awesome. He's answered your prayers already. Whew. And some of you have already gotten the answer. But you didn't like it. But you didn't like it. So you rejected the answer. But God is saying, because I love you so much, I'm going to send it again. You got time. I'm going to send it to you. God, Lord have mercy. I'm going to send it to you again because I love you just that much. My God. you, Lord. So he's posturing our heart so that you know how to receive from God, even when it don't quite sound right, even when it don't quite sound like a blessing, Lord. Is this a blessing, Lord, or is it? But it's you, oh God. Woo! So when it's you, oh God, we can't be like Peter when God says, rise, kill, and eat. People are like, that look nasty. I ain't never ate nothing nasty. I ain't eating nothing nasty now. Three times God brought it to him. After the third time, he lifted it back up. Don't reject what God sends. Because we don't understand. Don't reject the answer that God sends because it don't make sense. But the answer is on the way. Because to Peter, it didn't make no sense that salvation was coming to you and I. That's the love of Gentiles. But what is God doing now? Yesterday, not last week, and we can testify. But what is he doing now? He keeps on blessing. He keeps on restoring. He keeps on encouraging us because he wants us to walk in what he's doing now. Pastor.
I don't know about you. I know I got it in my Bible. I have to write it down sometimes. So the word was when you position yourself. When you position yourself, the word is released. That means it's already there. You're just in the wrong position. Myself in the right position. Lord, how do I do that? And sometimes we try to put something on someone else that we do. God tells us to do. I can't put what he told me to do on you. Or what did he tell you to do? As soon as I position myself, it's there. It was done before the foundation. God is not doing your breath. God already had your story written according to Psalms. In his book, all your stuff is written out. He just waits for me to get in position. How do I get in position? One of the things that God was sharing with us and sharing with Sister Pam, he was saying, Lord, you just spoke to me. You used my body and you done everything. Now it's doing this. And as soon as you begin to raise her hand, her strength, you have to get that. Because now she was making a connection. She was releasing something. And then she was receiving something because she God released. Oh my God, for glory. That's incredible. So, there temple. I'm trying to wait. Anybody who's got that job, take this. Let's get in position. Let's just posture ourselves. When we came in earlier, you see that the body's just a weak little crowd. Everybody that they had a time last night and they're not going to show up. Good! God wanted to tie folks to stay home. And as soon as you begin, you just start waiting. You just start clapping your hands. You just start talking. You posture yourself. And God said, now they're ready. I can release them. Oh, God. Y'all didn't get that. I don't want to win for 2,000. I don't want to win for 19,000. I need a fresh win. Well, get in the right place. Thank you.
Fresh wind. Fresh wind. Fresh wind. Thank you.
one that I can make a child. He gave his life to the Lord. We had salvation in the house. Salvation, the budget, salvation is in the house. Welcome to the body of Christ. I'm going to go tell somebody else. Welcome to the body of Christ. You're no longer someone that is looking at you. Are my brother in Christ. You are my sister. Oh, your brother. But I am your brother in the Lord. Because now we're both.
Bless the Lord. But for the glory of the God. But for the glory of God. The prophet was on there. They were coming to church and they were praying, God, do something special. What time is it? It's time for us to quit. They were asking God, will you do something? Do something special? Do something we hadn't seen him before? And God took a few. I told you, God don't like interference. That's why I keep people at home. there's going to be some interference, God will keep you. Y'all don't believe me. You know, that's all right. Keep some people at home. So that you don't have, you can have a breakthrough. How many of you got a breakthrough today? That's totally right. That's right. I got a breakthrough. I got a breakthrough. I didn't ask who didn't. It doesn't bother me that you didn't get one, because everything was present for you to get a breakthrough. Because there's a fresh wind. I see you, Joseph. I told you to do things. I got you up there, brother. Amen. 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 Come on. Now, what we have to do is savor this. We have to savor this. That means that it's like having a good meal. I get me a piece of that, and I put it in my mouth, and I begin to think. Last night I got a piece of biscuit. I ate it last night. It was good last night. But I'm saving right now because I'm gonna get me another biscuit. We had to put it in food. You got to savor that thing. That was good. Your taste buds got to be lined up. When you get saved, God align your taste buds. That was good. My pastor, that's good. So savor what God has done to you today. And just receive it. He released it. I receive it. God released it. I receive it. And in that receiving, I released what I was holding on to, so that I can make some room for what he's filling me with. You believe that? It's done in Jesus' name. It is done in Jesus' name. You asked him. Did you ask him? Okay. I ain't surprised. I ain't surprised. My God. Because you asked him. You prayed. You cried. And God, that's how those things.
Within our head, by your degrees, and how many scriptures you can quote, how many you cannot, what you know or what you think you know. He measures our heart. What's in your heart? Since we're talking about our hearts today, we need to examine our hearts. You know, we're any malice or unforgiveness or those things that really matter to God. Examine your heart and watch God do mighty things in your life. And watch the power of God come into your life and you that you never thought possible. Just did a wonderful job, powerful word, and then a prophetic word about a fresh wind. And when she mentioned the wind, it brought to me what God was, has been talking to me about storms. So, with all that you got today, prepare for some storms. Some storms are coming. Just when you think peace, storms are going to come. And it's not going to be far away. Prepare for the storms. It's not going to be pretty. It's going to be devastating. But you've been warned. Sometimes I don't like when God gives me these words. I don't want to say them. But I have to warn you that a storm, a mighty storm, category 5 storm, is coming. Prepare yourselves. Just as if the weathermen, when they announce the storm is coming, prepare your hearts. Prepare yourself for what you don't expect. It could hit your house when you least expect it. There was one, I think that went up into the, I think it went into the Mexico or somewhere, and it started out as a 4. But when it hit land, it was a 5. Devastated the place. So don't listen to the enemy when he says it's peacetime. This is not peacetime. This is wartime. You're in a war. You're on the front line. So you better be prayerful. You better be watchful. And the word that the Lord gave me, be diligent. Don't let nothing stop you from what God is saying and the warning that He's giving you. This is a prophetic word, and I know it's from God, or I wouldn't say it. We had a wonderful time. God is blessed. But when you go home, you get into your word. You be watchful. You be diligent about pursuing the things of God. You stand on the word of God, what He has said, what He has promised. And if when you've done all you can to stand, you just stand. Don't let the enemy move you. Don't let him make you think everything's all right, because it is not. There are missiles right now aimed at the United States of America. We think we're safe. Oh, it's over there. Oh, but the lights are flashing. The missiles are ready to go off to hit the United States of America. Flashing, waiting. So all I'm saying to you today, be diligent. Be watchful. Pray. And stand on the word of God. And say, so that you can get your own revelation about what's really going on in this earth realm and what the enemy has planned for his realm. Amen.
did you hear? He said, one thing about one thing about a fresh wind. A wind, you pick up a wind, but along with the three elements that brings about a fire, you have to have the elements that will burn. You have to have some wind. You have to have a fuel. And he said, along with the wind.
There you go.
He's along with the wind. That's going to be a fire. She didn't hear that. So I bring those two together. So there's going to be a fire.
We bless your name today. We give you all the glory and honor and praise. We honor your very presence in this place, Lord. We honor you, Lord God, in our homes. We honor you, Lord, in our cars. We honor you, Father, in everything that we do. We ask that you will continue to have your way, that you will continue to speak to our hearts, Lord God, that you will continue, Father God, to bring your word back to our remembrance, Lord. We ask, Father God, that you would help us to be fortified in your word, Father God, that we will be able to stand in the time of storm, Lord God, and after we've done all, that we'll be able to stand. Therefore, God, I pray that we would get in your word and that your word would get in us, Father God, that we will be able to tell somebody about this hope that we are so excited for. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, I ask you to keep each and every one of us, Lord, as we go to our homes. I thank you, Lord God, that we have everything that we need. We pray, Father God, that you will continue to watch over those that are sick, those that are shut in. We ask you to raise them up again, Father. Touch now by your Spirit in the name of Jesus. We will be careful to bless you and to give you glory and to give you honor in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.